is the birthright of every man or woman. Why don't you shut up about women, Stan? You're putting us off.
Women have a perfect right to play a part in our movement, Reg.
Why are you always on about women, Stan?
I want to be one.
What?
I want to be a woman. From now on, I want you all to call me Loretta.
A typically silly and very funny moment from Life of Brian, a religious satire starring the Monty Python comedy troupe. Life of Brian, which I enjoyed very much, is just one of five new movies we'll be reviewing on Sneak Previews, two film critics talking about the latest movies in town. Across the aisle from me, Roger Ebert, film critic of the Chicago Sun-Times.
And this is Gene Siskel, film critic for the Chicago Tribune. Now, besides Life of Brian, which I also like,
our next film is a comedy that's causing quite a bit of controversy. It's Life of Brian by the Monty Python comedy troupe, seen here regularly on public television. The Monty Python gang always makes fun of social customs, and Life of Brian makes fun of biblical movies. You know, the pictures that purport to tell the story of important religious figures, but always with a Hollywood cast of thousands. Life of Brian is the story of a guy named Brian Cohn. Mistaken at first for the Christ child, he grows up to be an oddball. But how could he help that? After all, he has a mother who likes to take him to public stonings. They're in the crowd wearing fake beards. Only men can attend.
By virtue of the authority vested in me. Oh, lay off. We haven't started yet. Come on. Who threw that? Who threw that stone? Come on. Sorry, I thought
we started.
Go to the back.
Oh, dear.
Always one, isn't there?
Now, where were we?
Look, I don't think it ought to be blasphemy. Just saying Jehovah. You're only making it worse for yourself.
Making it worse? How could it be worse? Jehovah, Jehovah, Jehovah.
I'm warning you. If you say Jehovah once more, right, who threw that? Come on, who threw that?
Was it you?
Yes.
Right.
Well, you did say Jehovah. Will you stop that? Come here. Now look, no one is to stone anyone until I blow this whistle. Do you understand? Even, and I want to make this absolutely clear, even if they do say Jehovah.
That was Monty Python member John Cleese conducting the stoning and getting stoned himself. Later, Brian Cohn, our reluctant hero, is thrust into the limelight. He joins an anti-Roman protest group and is arrested by Pontius Pilate, but this is no ordinary Pontius Pilate. In Life of Brian, this one can't pronounce his R's.
Hail Caesar!
Hail!
Only one survivor, sir.
Ah! Throw him to the floor.
What, sir?
Throw him to the floor. Ah! Now, what is your name,
Jew? Brian, sir.
Brian, eh?
No, Brian.
Ow! The little rascal has spirit?
Has what, sir?
Spirit?
Yes, he did, sir.
Hello. Spirit, sir. Bravado, a touch of daring do.
Oh, about 11, sir.
So, you dare to wade us?
To what, sir?
Strike him, Centurion, very roughly.
Ah! Oh, and throw him at the floor, sir. Throw him to the floor again, sir?
Oh, yes, throw him to the floor, please.
Funny stuff. Now, this film is controversial because Life of Brian does relate to the Christ story and does have some religious leaders now saying that it's therefore blasphemous. They obviously shouldn't see Life of Brian. In fact, I wonder if they did see Life of Brian. This movie isn't about Jesus. It's a parody of religious movies. And it's also one of the year's funniest films.
I think that's the key. Either you find it funny or you don't. I've read the newspaper reports about the religious leaders and groups who have said the film is offensive and blasphemous. I must say that I went looking for that in a way, and I just didn't find it. If anybody who sees Monty Python's Flying Circus on television is not going to find too much in this movie to upset or surprise them. It's a it's a funny, silly, harmless movie.
I feel bad having to defend it. You know, I wonder about these religious leaders who say things like this. Do they think that people who have deep personal religious faith will be have that faith shaken by a 90-minute movie? How shallow, how patronizing, how insulting to people of faith. This is a funny picture.
I think you're right, and I think now we should go on to something completely different. And we agree also on The Life of Brian. We both liked its brash satirical tone, and so we recommend that you see it.